সুর সরিদ উপকণ্ঠে গোদ্রুমে গৌরতীর্থে বসতি শিশুরবিকুঞ্জে ভক্তিপূর্বম বিনোদহ যুগলচরণ সেবা সৌক্ষ লাভাশয় অসৌ ব্রজ রসরসিকয়া পাদপদ্মাশ্রয়ে অত্র। সুর সরিদ উপকণ্ঠে গোদ্রুমে গৌরতীর্থে বসতি শিশুরবিকুঞ্জে ভক্তিপূর্বম বিনোদহ যুগলচরণ সৌক্ষ লাভাশয়া অসৌ ব্রজ রসরসিকয়া পাদপদ্মাশ্রয়ে অত্র। গৌড়ীয় গোষ্ঠীপতি শিশিল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাঠ ভক্তিবিনোদ ধারা ক্যান নেভার বি এক্সটিংক্ট। ভক্তিবিনোদ ধারা ক্যান নেভার বি স্টপড। দো উই নো সিচুয়েশন চেঞ্জিং ডে বাই ডে, উই আর ওয়াচিং হুইচ ইজ নট ইউজুয়াল, আই মিন আনইউজুয়াল থিং উই আর ওয়াচিং। That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking. That maybe externally you cannot find Bhaktivinoda Dhara extensive way. But still be sure, like Phalgu Nadi, a Nadi there in Gaya Dham, you can find sand and sand all around. Somehow if you dig some little bit, you can find water inside. So water flow is there, but very secretly. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada wanted to speak that Bhaktivinoda Dhara can never be extinct, Bhaktivinoda Dhara can never be stopped. Though situation can change, but still you can find Bhaktivinoda Dhara flowing very secretly through the heart of those pure devotees. Those who are not going to expose their heart in front of you openly, that see, I am in Bhaktivinoda Dhara. No. You will have to do bhajan, you will have to realize, have to go up to that level, then you can realize. Because self-effulgent, Guru Vaishnav, Dham, Nam, Supreme Lord, I mean deities, they are all self-effulgent. They can expose themselves in front of you, provided you are qualified. Otherwise, you cannot understand what is what. Cannot understand. Today is the appearance of Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Actually, Vyasa Puja. Today is the Vyasa Puja or Gauriya Vaishnava society, not Gauriya Math. For the whole Gauriya Vaishnava society, because sectarian attitude is not applicable in this case. Vaishnava is open. Yesterday I was speaking. Vaishnava is doing for the whole world. There should not be any prejudicial idea, conception with you. What to speak about Vaishnava? A real scientist always doing everything for the whole world. Not that this scientist is from India, so it's our benefit, not that. So this is the case. But I feel shy, because today is the Abhirbhav Tithi appearance day, Abhirbhav Tithi of Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur. But I have nothing to pay as a, you know, shraddha. Even no flower is there. I am so poor. What kind of flower I mean? Suman, pure mind. That is called actually flower. So I have no flower to pay dandavat and give puspanjali unto the lotus feet of Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So poor condition in which I am put into, there is no way out. But maybe there is some way out, I cannot accept, I cannot follow. That is this kind of miserable condition I have in my life. But one thing is sure, what I cannot see, what I cannot feel, what I cannot understand, how it is possible for me to celebrate the Abhirbhav Tithi of that gigantic personality, super personality, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. What I cannot see, what I cannot feel, what I cannot understand, how it is possible to get in connection with that objective, that's, you know, Mahajan, to pay Puspanjali? I am blind, I cannot see. My mind is material, I cannot feel. My heart is also blocked. In this condition, I am just material people. In this condition, what I cannot see, what I cannot feel, what I cannot understand, is it possible for me to give Puspanjali unto the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur? Though I can push you behind me and go ahead first to pay Puspanjali unto the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that is the first question. We should feel this question, understand the answer. Actually, aprakito vastu ko bhu prakito gochar noy. Aprakito vastu, those are transcendental objects. Dham, nam, parikar, vaishishta. Anything we have no power to look. If I see Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then Bhaktivinoda Thakur is an objective of my enjoyment. I can see how fat Bhaktivinoda Thakur is, how fair Bhaktivinoda Thakur is, how nice his eyes. Not that. If I can see Gauranga Mahaprabhu, I can see. You can see. So Gauranga Mahaprabhu is a material object, so you can enjoy. Bonded soul cannot see. Bonded soul cannot see Supreme Lord. Bonded soul cannot see Dham. Bonded soul cannot see Guru Vaishnava. They misunderstand. They cannot understand. That's why it is told that aprakita vastu kabhu prakita gochar noy. Self-effulgent. Guru, Vaishnava, Bhagavan, Nam, Dham, everything. So I can put one question before you. Have you seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur? But you can reply, Maharaj, no. If somebody put question in front of me, Maharaj, have you seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur? Have you seen, Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur? Have you seen Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj? I don't understand what to answer. Why? It's simple. Your age is 60. How you can see Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada? No, I am not speaking about that kind of philosophy. I am speaking about transcendental philosophy. If I say I have not seen Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, still it is lie. If I say I have seen Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, it is also lie. If I say I have not seen, why? What is the adjustment? What is the outcome? What is the balance? Maharaj, balance is that I should speak this way under the guidance of Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj, under the guidance of Bhakti Vidya Madhu Goswami Maharaj, under the guidance of Srila Keshava Goswami Maharaj, I have the privilege to look the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Right I am sitting in Vyasasana. Little bit, not fully, maybe. The beauty of the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, maybe not 100% exposed in front of me, but still I am bound to say, that by the mercy of Gurudev, by the mercy of Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Vinod Puri Goswami Maharaj, I have the privilege, advantage to look the beauties of Bhakti Vinod Thakur. This is correct answer, balanced answer. Actually, long ago, not now, maybe 180 years back, maybe 190 years, I cannot calculate, I cannot remember the date. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was there in Rambagan house doing bhajan, very, very. A Vaishnav, Grihe Thako, Bone Thako, Sada Hari Bole Dako. Anywhere a Vaishnav living, maybe in New York, but still he is staying in Vrindavan. Maybe a Vaishnav staying in Rome, but still he is staying in Vrindavan. You cannot believe. You cannot believe. It is not for possible for a Vaishnav to live anywhere except Vrindavan. So that time Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to do bhajan in Rambagan. Rambagan, that Bhakti Bhavan is Vrindavan itself for Bhaktivinoda Thakur. But you cannot feel. You cannot understand. How is that possible, Maharaj? Logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. I many times told before, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is staying there. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur is staying in Vrindavan. Many devotees coming to meet with him, to pay dandavat, some with material ends, some with some nice objective, good objectives. Many people, mixed people coming, mixed people. One day, Prabhupada sitting at the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, long ago, not now, long ago, even that time maybe Gaudiya Math was not established, I mean not came in the material world, from the transcendental world. Because Gaudiya Math coming down from transcendental world, Vrindavan, Gauriya Mat is Dibbat Bindar Annukalpat Dramadasimat Naga Singha Sanosto Sisi Radha Sile Govinda Dibbou Prasthalibi Sebba Manus Marami. This is called Gauriya Mat. If you cannot feel that Gauriya Mat is Yogopit shown by Rupapad, shown by Rupakosnipad, then you should leave Gauriya Mat. Go. You are going to make Gauriya Mat a dustbin. From outside you are getting garbage and putting into Gauriya Math. This is your duty. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur identified himself as the sweeper of Namhatta. You forget. Because you want to take undue advantage of the reputation of Guru Vaishnava. That is your cut. I have seen in my life. To preach big way, sometime we are going to take advantage of our Guru Varga. We want to prove I have very deep relation with that Vaishnava, so that after he gone, I can get the total field of that preaching field. It's like you know, canvasser, you know, canvasser going here, there. But those who are pure Vaishnava, they don't care. They never try to take the advantage of the reputation of Guru Vaishnava. Maybe he has done some seva. He never liked to. Srila Siddhanti Maharaj speaking, I was bound to print it 20 years back. That after Gurudev gone, then the real identity of Vaishnava's disciple can be exposed in front of public. With what desire he came here to take shelter onto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava? What reason? To serve Guru Vaishnava or to get service from Guru Vaishnava? What is the reason? Can you say? Can you touch Gita? Can you touch Salagram and say, come Salagram in front of me, I can speak. So this is not good. Prabhupada never wanted to take that kind of advantage. Guru Varga never wanted to take that kind of advantage. be careful about them. That time Vimala Prasad was sitting beside the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Some people coming, immaterial people, so-called devotee. Actually not devotee, so-called. And paying dandavat to Bhaktivinoda, paying pranam to Bhaktivinoda Thakur and discussing something. That time Bhaktivinoda Thakur was not sick. It's a little bit okay. That man looking at Vimala Prasad, you see, for a long time I am serving, I am coming here. Because it is the instruction of Bhaktivinoda Thakur to come here. He requests me to come here. I read Gita, interpretation. Bhaktivinoda Thakur likes to hear very much. I come here to explain Gita in front of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. That people speaking to Prabhupada, follow, that man speaking to Prabhupada many times. I've been there. I was going there to meet Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He used to give me instructions. You read Gita. I like to hear your explanation. Prabhupada speaking, you have not seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur. What do you say? I used to meet him usually. I read Gita, I say, no? Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada again saying, you have not seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur ever. You have not, never you have seen. What do you say? I say, you meet Bhaktivinoda Thakur many times. No! You have not seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur in your whole life. Then the man become very angry and gone. Repeatedly I am speaking that I have seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I used to go. Prabhupada said, you have not seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Those who demand that we are the family member of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they also could not see Bhaktivinoda Thakur. It's not possible to see Bhaktivinoda Thakur with this material eyes. It's a very important thing. We have our false ego, vanity, so we want to speak this way. I have seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I know Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I know all the philosophy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This way we can explain. You know already Bhaktivinoda Thakur, how from, is from a big family. Datta family, big family. Big Jamindar, landlord, pigs. After that their condition gradually, their material condition fall down. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur when took birth, that time the condition, financial condition was not at all good. Not at all good. Bhaktivinoda Thakur that time when a small boy used to come to Gwari. Gwari means Krishnanagar. To take education. That time there was a village area. Gwari to take education here in school. After that gradually, you know, so long history, I don't like to go through some. Though it is good, but still I have no time. I would like to touch those Siddhanta, Vichara Bhaktivinoda Thakur, the speciality of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, so that I can get some momentum in my bhajan, get some extra power in my bhajan. So also the Jivani, the life history of Vaishnava is all the way good, I know. But we Gauriya Vaishnavas habituated to touch or Siddhanta, Vichar, because we like to touch the transcendental feature of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Not that Bhaktivinoda Thakur little bit fit, little bit fat, for a fair body. No. I like to touch the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I like to touch the transcendental bani feature of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So, if I have that kind of expectation, desired, then I should go through the Siddhanta Vichar of Guru Varga. How to realize, wow, who is Bhaktivinoda Thakur? What he wanted to do for us all? That is the main point. In the whole life, we have seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur struggling with poverty. Struggling with poverty all the time. You cannot understand. Bhaktivinoda Thakur enjoying the full kripa, used to enjoying the full kripa of Vidyasagar Mahasaya, that time erudite scholar, big scholar, Pandit Ishwarchandra Vidyasagar. That time Bhaktivinoda Thakur manifesting a lila, he is a student of Vidyasagar Mahasaya. Vidyasagar used to love him very much. So intelligent, so meritorious. Used to love him, special care. One day in the class when Vidyasagar Mahasaya passing one remark that is there in Shuddhodaya Gantho, not Haribhakti Shuddhodaya. Haribhakti Shuddhodaya is a part of Narad Puran, not that. I say Shuddhodaya. Haribhakti Shuddhodaya is an important book. It's from Narad Puran, a part of, it's very important. All Amar Guru Varga and Goswamis, they used to put reference from this. But Vidyasagar Mahasaya writing Vyakaran books, Panini Vyakaran, extract of Panini Vyakaran, how easy way representation, so that people can at least get in touch with Vyakaran, where we can get that kind of meritorious, otherwise this kind of language, ordinary people always fear, oh, Sanskrit, oh. Because they know, you have to go deep. Deep concentration, deep meditation can give you entry. Otherwise possible, not possible. Now, one day, in Shuddhodaya, Vidyasagar wrote, and in the class Vidyasagar was speaking, that Supreme Lord is impersonal, cannot be seen, it's there. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur stand up. Pandit Masai, if you never mind, I have one question. What question? Have you seen Supreme Lord? After that you are going to pass this kind of remark? Or you are passing remarks? Because usually you speak what you cannot see, what you cannot feel, you are not going to pass any remark. Usually you are speaking. So I think you have seen Supreme Lord. So you are going to pass this kind of remark. The Supreme Lord is impersonal. Vidyasagar Maharaj became stunned. Stop. Actually, I have no idea about Supreme Lord. So I should not pass any kind of remark. You are right. Vidyasagar Mahasaya helping Bhaktivinoda Thakur get a service there in Orisha. Master. Headmaster. In Kotak or Bhadrak, I forget. There. Doing service there gradually. After that, one by one, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was able to catch the attention of British government. British government means those who are in higher level, taking control of different offices, and they could realize that personality is not ordinary personality. At the same time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was appearing in different examination passing. After that, they recruit as a big officer, and ultimately was recruited as a deputy magistrate. Ultimately, I am speaking in gist. But whole life, Bhaktivinoda Thakur never wanted to break rules and regulations. Bhaktivinoda Thakur never wanted to take shelter of. Bhaktivinoda Thakur never wanted to take shelter of. Bhaktivinoda Thakur never wanted to take shelter of. Undue advantage. Never. He was full of truthfulness all the time. At all, any kind of eventuality can come in life, but still, he is not going to, you know, displaced even one fraction of inch from his stand position. That is called personality. How you can understand? He is a man of personality, man of action. How you can detect? If you go through his life, you can have the scrutiny. Then you can realize he never want to get displaced from his own position. Prabhupada usually used to say, if I speak about that absolute truth, the whole society can go against me. That should not be the reason for why I can go away from absolute truth. The whole society can go against me if I speak about the absolute truth. They can come in team to fight with me. Still, Prabhupada speaking, if I change my decision, if I change my siddhanta, if I change everything, then I can never become a Vaishnava. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is equal to Gauriya Math. I like to explain gradually how and Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the first personality. He was the first man, first personality to represent Gauriya philosophy in front of foreign people. Otherwise, where you are? Coming from there, here. He was the first man, he was the first personality to represent Gauriya Darshan in front of foreign people in different language. Sanskrit, Bengali, Hindi, Urdu, English, different kind of language. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to speak fluently. He was from a big family. He was from a big family. As usually he was habituated. So, automatically he was able to catch the attention of, actually Bhaktivinoda Thakur less interested to catch the attention of British people. Bhaktivinoda Thakur always interested to catch the attention of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. But still, he was engaged. Bhaktivinoda Thakur completed background, everything, all darshan shastra, everything. After that, he went on doing his own duty, this, that. After that, finally, he was engaged in as a governor, I mean, controller of the whole Jagannath temple. British government gave responsibility. So many cases, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was posted here in Krishnanagar. Sometime Bhaktivinoda Thakur was posted there in Srirampur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur compiled Chaitanya Sikshamrita in Srirampur. You don't know. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to write continuously about, realize, Supreme Lord, the eternal Parshad. The Pranam Mantra itself can expose the mystery. Namo Bhaktivinodaya Sachidananda Namine Gauru Shakti Sarupayo Rupanugo Varayate. Those who are Rupanugo devotees, is the topmost among them. Seventh Goswami. So you cannot put any sectarian attitude about Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the treasure of whole Gauriya Vaishnava society. He is doing whole for all. So British government was 100% sure he is the only personality who can get control over this Orissa district, Puri district. Puri district and Jagannath temple itself. That time so many unusual incidents happened. One yogi was there, Bishkisan. very loose character by having some yoga power. He announced that I am that Mahavishnu, I can start Ras on that day. In the jungle, he make one, you know, shelter in jungle and doing yoga. All so many Matajis, they are so foolish. They go there to take kippa from me, but they also they lose character, everything done. Gradually information coming into the pocket of Bhaktivinoda Thakur about this situation. Bhaktivinoda Thakur get in touch with British government and took the advantage of police force. Automatically he was the governor there. Then reaching that place, jungle, with full troops, and meeting that yogi, hey, who are you? He is so speaking all rubbish again, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur asking one by one question. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur could understand that he is making a colony here to put some extra, get some extra advantage in society. That kind of effort should be eradicated. Otherwise, corruption can enter into whole each sector of society. We cannot allow. So he was arrested by the police force, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He gave warning to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I can kill you. Okay, you can kill me, no problem. I shall see what a man you are like. I will see what a man you are like. Okay. Then after that, out of yoga power, he was able to make Bhaktivinoda Thakur a little bit sick. Whole family member sick. All small children, they are sick. But still Bhaktivinoda Thakur, not changing decision, putting him in lockup for a long time. After that, judgment was there. He was imprisoned. He was giving punishments for 2 years or 3 years, I don't. From jail, he is putting some influence on Bhaktivinoda Thakur and his family to make them. Usually at present in Vaishnava society, this kind of thing happening. Yes, many devotees crying, Maharaj, they are making black magic against me, I am feeling sick. What black magic can do? If you are doing Krishna bhajan, if you are going to stay under the shelter of Bhakti, Prabhupada, Guru Bharga, what that black magic can do? What harm they can do to you? It's a challenge, open challenge. Hari Bhakta, those who are doing Hari bhajan, for them, Sudarshan Chakra itself staying all around. We have seen the autobiography of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur reading Bhagavatam and that yogi throwing missile, black magic missile. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur reading Bhagavatam and missile moving around him, cannot touch. Yes. This way actually Bhaktivinoda Thakur was rigid in his standpoint, very rigid, solid. In his standpoint, I'm not going to change. After that, that Biskisan die in jail itself. After that, so many cases like such cases happened. Bhaktivinoda Thakur arrest them and put in jail. When Bhaktivinoda Thakur was given charge to take control of a seva of Jagannath Ji Maharaj, then Bhaktivinoda Thakur, whole day taking care of all, what kind of seva going on, what problem. But still, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, it was the usual practice, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to make a asan, a seat, there where? Near? Near actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu lotus feet there. In Jagannath temple. Jagannath temple, evening time, it was the usual practice. Bhaktivinoda used to sit there. Automatically, all devotees coming to hear him, attend him. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying, I don't know, every day whenever I enter temple, somebody coming to give sweet dal to me. Because I was fond of that sweet dal. Who knows who is coming? Somebody coming, take this prasadam. Every day. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I don't know the reason. What is the arrangement of Jagannath? Whenever I enter temple, somehow somebody coming with sweet dal and giving. My Guru Maharaj also fond of sweet dal. I also like sweet dal. So nice. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, every day somebody coming and giving me sweet dal. Maybe it is the arrangement of Jagannath. So it was the usual practice. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to sit just beside the, you know, there is some footprint of Jagannath, Mahaprabhu, and they are doing kirtan. Still today, you can go and see some group of Oriya devotees and some other, they are coming and doing kirtan. Every day, 7 o'clock. Every day. Many people could not understand the feature of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Many people criticizing. Yeah, no tilak, no mala, nothing. Hey, usually coming and speaking. Some say, some devotee, nice devotee. He couldn't understand the mood of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He coming in front of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and speaking. In Jagannath Ballabh Udvan, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to sit there to Ishtagasthi. That Babaji Maharaj speaking, don't go there, he is not Vaishnav. Then the information came to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur laughing, really I am not Vaishnav? Who told I am Vaishnav? Then one day that Babaji Maharaj running and coming, please excuse me, please. What happens, Babaji Maharaj? I misunderstood you. Because you have no tilak, no, you know, kanti. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur laughing. You are right. Actually, how I can get kanti and tilak? But still today, Jagannath not arranging Gurudev for me. That's why I am, oh really. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to do Harinam. It is written there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to do Harinam, not given by Guru, any Guru. But he is eternal parsad of Mahaprabhu. Eternal parsad of Mahaprabhu, but used to do Harinam in one Tulsi Mala. You practice. The Babaji Maharaj laughing. One Babaji Maharaj there, his name is Sarupdas Babaji Maharaj. He is a nice devotee. Whole day doing Sankirtan, Harinam. And the evening time, it was the usual practice of Babaji Maharaj to come out of Bhajan Kutir and do Tulsi Parikram and Kirtan. And some devotee that time used to give him Jagannath Prasadam. That was his Madhukuri. He never going anywhere. That was the usual practice. Babaji Maharaj not going anywhere. And though some devotee is coming in Jagannath Prasadam, Sabji, Dal. That was the Prasadam. After whole day gone, after Kirtan, Babaji Maharaj taking Prasadam and taking some rest. After then again do Bhajan whole day. It is the responsibility of Vishwambar. It is the responsibility of Vishwambar. It is the responsibility of Jagannath, Krishna. It is the responsibility of Radharani to arrange prasadam, those who are not going to beg. Very sick, lying in bed, cannot go. Always crying. And Radharani speaking, Lalita, go there. Go there, give bread and water. Give bread and water, everything. That devotee is feeling pain. After that, taking water and chapati, he feel okay. So many incidents. What to speak about Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj also. So many things happen. You are not going to take any information about Mahapurush. You can get bumper success in your life if you try to go through the life history of Guru Vaishnava, how they used to live their life. Then you can get success in Rupanuga Bhajan. Living there, you can sit with Ujjal Nirmali in open, in a closed room. How you can come out successful? You should know. Practically, you should know. How different way they are doing bhajan still today. But people saying, there is no Vaishnava at present, really. I am not Vaishnava, for that I cannot pass that kind of remark that nobody is Vaishnava in this world. I have no right to speak that way. Maybe some Vaishnava is there, who can say? But situation changing, situation going down, that much I can say. Under the guidance of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, this much I can say. So actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that time, there was no printing press. He is writing all Gita, Bhagavatam, handwriting. Bhaktivinoda Thakur getting copy. Whole. Shandarva. Oh, so tough. You have money in your bag. You can go to market. You give me Shatsandarva. You can buy. You can. You are getting so many books. You have money power. But that time you can realize how those six Goswamis, how Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, how they used to compile books. Wow, big problem. Where you can get? Now, if I like to consult, you know, Vishnu Puran, tuck Vishnu Puran from bookshelf. Or I open internet. Even I am not going to take trouble, I can open internet fine. That time you can realize what kind of trouble. So weak, tough. That time in Orissa, when Bhaktivinoda Thakur was there in Puri, he used to copy all books and different. By the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, on and on. You are successful. Because his character and behavior, Vaishnava Adige itself one kind of preaching center. A Vaishnava, you can test. A Vaishnava sitting anywhere. Anywhere Vaishnava sitting. You can see that Vaishnava is there. But automatically preaching can be done. Automatically. Rupa Sanatan in forest, never going to New York or Washington, nowhere. Where is the topmost preacher in the world? Rupa Bad, Rupa Goswami Pad, Sanatan Goswami Pad. Who not? They are all topmost preacher. So see, you see, this way Bhaktivinoda Thakur ultimately open one bhajan kutir there near Haridas Thakur bhajan kutir. Haridas Thakur bhajan kutir, Sargo Dwar, there. Also, first Bhaktivinoda Thakur went near Jagannath temple where Prabhupada took birth, that place. Paramvija Madhava Goswami Maharaj took control over that place. And that place we go there. Why? Is the Abhirvah place of Prabhupada. Utkale Purushottamat. So many people, they are passing bad remark, unusual remark about Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was not so tough like Prabhupada. Bhagavan, very easy. Yeah, very tough actually. Bhaktivinoda never speak this way. Bhaktivinoda used to arrange, you know, kirtan here. You permit, hey, don't do that kind of kirtan. Why? Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we have seen, after retirement, Bhaktivinoda Thakur make this bhajan kutir. After retirement, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Sananda Sukada Kunjidhya. And well, in the last stage of his service, Bhaktivinoda Thakur took decision to go to Vrindavan to do exclusive bhajan. But somehow, for some purpose, official purpose, he was bound to go there in Tarakeshwar, Hooghly. Then night time, Mahadev coming, hey! Shankar Bhagavan. You took decision, you have taken decision to go to Vrindavan? Eh? You don't know this is secret Vrindavan? Who can do this seva? You will have to do. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Then onward, Bhaktivinoda Thakur took decision not to go to Vrindavan, this seva given by Vaishnavanam Jatha Sambhu. But still, by that time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur procured one small piece of land near Radhakund. That is also Sananda Sukhada Gunji there. Usually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to go sometime, Prabhupada also, going there, doing bhajan there, and coming back to do Gauranga Seva. Be careful that Bhaktivinoda Thakur was given this name Nodia Prakash. Why? Nodia Prakash is one magazine, Maharaj, I know, you know. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur itself is Nodia Prakash. The glories of Nadia, the glories of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was exposed by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So, who was the first man to expose the glories of? Though it was there, eternal. Dham is eternal, though everybody knowing. But still, who could know Bhaktivinoda Thakur? That's why one name of Bhaktivinoda Thakur is Nadia Prakash. He started Nodia Prakash, Sajjanta Sani, so nice books. Sajjanta Sani, very nice article. Bhaktivinoda Thakur started Sajjanta Sani, Patrika, Nodia, so nice. Nodia Prakash was published late, first Sajjanta Sani, first. So this way actually, he started publishing this. There are so many magazines and books. And when Bhaktivinoda Thakur doing service as a deputy magistrate, in the tiffin time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to write kirtan. Saranagati, Kalyan Kalpataru, Jamuna Bababali, so many one parts. If you have the time to go through those kirtan, have the time and you will have to make time. Then you can understand the Baba Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Rupanuga Varayate, and the sloka you know I started with, the feeling of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur himself writing. Bhaktivinoda Thakur himself writing. Suro Sarid Upakante mean? Suro Sarid mean? Surodhani. Surodhani mean? Ganga. There is so many synonym. You have to make a huge amount of stock of word. Then you can switch over from one word to another word to make the balance of, you know, kirtan. Otherwise you can break. Follow? Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, so, you know, we are always dancing by the writing of whom? Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Because it's so easy representation. You are dancing because when we have the chance to go through the writings of Prabhudananda, so high class, topmost darshan. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur, when writing something, speaking something, so catchy, so lucite, so easy representation, it can touch the heart of even plain, ordinary people. And they can grow the desire to become a devotee. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to write this way, one by one. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, Suro Sarid Upakante Godrume Gauro Tirthe is the topmost place. Be careful. The topmost place where you are staying. Gurudev Boro Kipakori Gauro Bonomaje Godrume Diachostan. How lucky I am that Guru Maharaj arranged some place. Though I don't know what is bhajan, but still Guru Maharaj arranged some place for me, some gosala from me. Some Harikatha place for me. Yes, I am lucky. I think I am lucky. Gurudev arranged everything. Bhaktivinoda Thakur also writing this way. Suro Sarid Upakante. Upakante means Upakante. at the bank of Ganga, at the bank of Suro Sarid Upagante Gauro Tirtha, is a Gauro Tirtha. It's a Vrindavan Dham. More than Vrindavan Dham. Written by Prakasananda, Prabodhananda Saraswati Pad, Sarup Gosai. More than Navadvip Dham is equal to Vrindavan, but still more than. Because you have the scope, you have the privilege to enjoy the kripa of Nityananda Gaur with anartha. With anartha, there is the extra facility. With anartha, if you are, you cannot do bhajan, but with anartha you are trying. You can cry and speak, Ha Nityananda Ho Gaur. We are fallen soul, we cannot go by our personal effort. Never we can come out. You try to help us. In that case, Nityananda can help us. Gauranga can help us. This way, the meaning you try to understand, Suro Sarid Upagante, Gauro Tirthe. It is Vrindavan, Gauro Tirtha. At the same time, it is written, Surabhi Kunje, Goddume Gauro Tirthe. At the same time, Surabhi Kunje, Basati Bhakti Purvam Vinodaha. Vinod, sitting here, trying to do bhakti unto your lotus feet, trying and trying. Where? Sitting? Vinod, where sitting? Surabhi Kunje. Basati Surabhi Kunje Bhakti Purvam Vinodaha. With fervent effort, with strong effort, trying to get the kipa of your lotus feet. Bhaktivinoda Thakur crying. So you see, Suro Sarid Upakante Godrume Gauro Tirthe Basati Sisuro Vikinje Bhakti Purvam Vinadaha. Why you are sitting? Jugala Charano Shoksho Sheva Lava Sayasau Asau. Asau, Asau, Asau. He is Krishna. When you point out, then you say Asau, Asau, Asau. In Sanskrit. So, that Vinod sitting here to understand the glories of that divine love affair of Radha Govinda. Jugala Charano Shoksho Lava Asaya. Love Asaya in Sanskrit, joint actually. Love Asaya, Lava Asaya. Aso sitting here, taking shelter of Godrum Dham. So many kirtan. Kabe Gaurabane Suradhani Tate Haradhe Hagovinda Boli. You are not doing kirtan. So problem going to touch you. Do kirtan with open heart. Do kirtan. Close your room. Not for exhibition, not for swaying. You do kirtan. Can get power. I promise you. Try to understand. Vava Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Jugala Charano. Shoksho lava sayaso brajo raso rasika. You are sitting here without any guidance? No, no, no. You are wrong. Why? Brajo raso rasikaya pad padmasrayatro. I have taken shelter of those, you know, devotees, Rupanuga devotees. So I am not fancifully coming here. Brajo raso rasikaya. Those who are having Brajarasa inside their heart, flowing, overflowing. Their heart is overflowing with Brajarasa. I am taking shelter of them. So why you are want to put some allegation against me? Brajarasa Sikaya Pada Padma Sraya Atro. Atro, Atro, my here I am sitting. Atro, here I am sitting with this desire. So you see. And the Panamanta itself, Rupanuga Varayate. Gauriamat is equal to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Yes. Gauriamat is just equal to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Because whatever we have, given by Bhaktivinoda Thakur. But be sure Bhaktivinoda is not Sahajiya. You are speaking this way. Prabhupada became very sorry. After Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, everybody coming, you are so tough. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was not so tough. He allows kirtan, this, that, you say. Prabhupada laughing. Who told? Who told Bhaktivinoda Thakur was in favor of those, this kind of kirtan? But we have seen Bhaktivinoda sitting doing harinam and kirtan going on. He used to, you know, bring, call kirtan pradipa sandhapur. Prabhupada laughing. Who told you? Bhaktivinoda Thakur is very clever to catch bird, you know. Those Vaishnava, they are very clever to catch bird. They arrange prasadam, nice, nice facility. Ultimately, want to catch that bird. So that, that bird can be engaged in Gaur Seva, Gauranga Seva. They are very clever. They are putting some network. So some bird can come and we can catch those birds and put as a Puspanjali unto the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada and Gauranga. They are very clever. So you see, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was not Sahajiya. You know the mood of Bhaktivinoda Thakur? Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to do bhajan here. He used to call the Sahajiya, this kirtan party there for Santapur. They are doing kirtan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur not going to listen even a single word of that kirtan. Eh? Why? We have seen he is sitting there. He is sitting, but doing bhajan and pass away to Vrindavan. The Sahajiya, they are doing kirtan. Some people, they are gossiping to take biri. Oh, let us go, there is nice kirtan. They are coming and have the chance to look Bhaktivinoda Thakur in asan sitting with closed eyes. They don't know the mood of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur not going to hear even a single word of that kirtan. He is totally engaged in Radha Govinda Seva in Vrindavan and Gauranga. But people say, we have seen Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, just sitting near kirtan, Prabhupada says, you are foolish. He gives you the scope. He is making one network so that common people can come to hear kirtan, have the chance to look Bhaktivinoda Thakur, get some sukriti. Gangar parasi ay paschate pavon, darshane pavitra karo ei tomar gun. A Vaishnava can purify you by his holy darshan. A Vaishnava can purify you by his holy darshan itself. If you touch Ganga water, if you go take deep into Ganga water, then you can get purified. You know how tough Bhaktivinoda Thakur was. Don't speak that way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was swaya. You go through Jaiva Dharma, you go through Shiksha Amrita, you go through Mahaprabhu Shiksha, you go through all kirtan, then you show me where Bhaktivinoda Thakur is Sahajiya. You speaking this way? Where you find Bhaktivinoda Thakur Sahajiya? In Tattva Vigev, Tattva Vivek, writing one, very gist, all Tattva, no question of Sahajiya. When Bhaktivinoda Thakur was there previously, when Bhaktivinoda Thakur, long ago, he was the topmost writer in this society. What to speak, I am bound to speak. I am bound to speak that way, somebody can fight with me. Even Bhaktivinoda Thakur was more elevated than Bankim Chanta Chattopadhyay, who write so many Bande, Mataram, everything writing. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur was more elevated than him. Regarding, but still Bhaktivinoda Thakur never wanted to get name and fame. Never. While Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to give the charge, office charge to Bankim Chattopadhyay in Krishnanagar portfolio. You know portfolio changing? I am in charge, I am going, then I will have to open all the file and put everything, evidence, then I will have to go to other place. That time, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was there in Krishnanagar as deputy magistrate and opening all file in front of Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay to show you. This is the latest situation, status. In between, they are staying there together. So, on lizard time, Bhaktivinoda used to speak very sweetly about Gita, this day in front of Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. He was so puffed up. He thinks, I am more elevated than him. Ah, who is going to care? Bhaktivinoda was very politely speaking. If you can understand Gita this way, they can feel but he don't care. He writing Gita some in his own way. He is going to represent the character of Krishna in his own way. That is the fallacy with them. They are noble writer, big writer. Big writer in India, who not knowing the name of Bankimchandra Chattopadhyay. Bande Mataram, this song written by him. Anandamar, at the time of freedom fighting, he write big, big, you know, so that young batch when read, they can get hot blood, they can start to give their life for motherland. So powerful man, but still could not realize the kripa of Krishna Gauranga. He got the scope, but still lose. Bhaktivinoda was speaking so, but he is representing Gita in his own way. He is right. He wants to represent the character of Krishna as a, you know, material hero. Bankim Chattopadhyay. That time Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing one nice Prem Pradeep. Prem Pradeep, one book, which is just sufficient to give you enough momentum so that you can become ready to throw your life for motherland. Motivation can be done for motherland. Who's nice is one kind of noble, very small, very nice. Prem Pradeep. If you go and read, you can get power. So nice. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur compiling Jaiva Dharma, these are so many. All the tikas, Chaitanya Charitamrita Bhashya, Chaitanya Bhagavat Bhashya, what not? Brahma Sangita Bhashya, what not? All represented by Bhaktivinoda. We are ever grateful to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. We can never pay to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. We are ever grateful to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He is starting preaching the glories of Gauranga Mahaprabhu in front of all foreign countries. In Calcutta University Hall, in big, big society, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to speak. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to speak in Jorasakor, the Nobel Prize winner, you know, Rabindranath Tagore, you know? Nobel Prize winner. His brother, your elder brother, had some friendship with Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to speak him Dada, Dada. Dada means elder brother. He used to go there, stay some time. Very nice, speaking Harikatha, discussion. Ishtagosti. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to speak Harikatha in Jorasakar. Harinam, one book I published already in English, you know? Harinam, this lecture was given by Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Jorasakar. Hall, lecture hall. Speaking. What is Harinam? Once. Tear twice, very small book, Harinam. This way, all the way, we are going to pay respect to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. We can never pay to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. We are ever grateful to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Who told Bhaktivinoda Thakur Sahajya? Prabhupada speaking, just now Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, 1914. Ashad, Rath Yatra, Gundi Jamandin previous day. Just Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, you are going to put that kind of allegation against me? Bhaktivinoda Thakur, no Sahajiya. Bhaktivinoda wanted to represent the actual darshan. He wanted to seek the kripa of Gauranga Mahaprabhu 100%. Many, many important personalities, they are misled by Sahajiyas. They are all misled by Sahajiyas. If they have the chance to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur, 100% I am sure, they can live that track and they can try to adopt this Bhaktivinoda Dhara. But we are really unlucky. We are lucky, but still we are unlucky. We cannot follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur totally. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in such a way, if you open all the books of Bhaktivinoda Thakur one by one, I can show you what kind of representation there in the name of Varnasam Dharma, so many people speaking all rubbish. They are not going through Bhaktivinoda Thakur, not speaking. One or two examples I can speak. Maybe they can attack me. I know. But I'm bound to speak. Regarding Vaishnava Dharma, 2-3 days I was, 7 days I was speaking. In Vrindavan also, 7 days continuously on Varnasana. Long ago, 20 years back. Bhaktivinoda was speaking. Varnasam Dharma, you know, according to Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, according to karma, Chaturvarna Maya Sushtam Guna Karma Vibhagashaha. According to qualities and their duties, I want to sacrifice, segregate. The segregation was done scientifically. Some minister, those are foolish, they are speaking, oh, rubbish! There should not be any social system, nothing, all one caste. Are you? Caste is not problem. You are foolish. I cannot say I can kill all Brahman and keep only Shudra. Not that. Application is defective. Follow. I am not going to say that I can kill all Brahman. I am not going to say I can kill all Kshatriya like Parshuram. Not that. Krishna speaking, only we need scientific application of that Varnasam Dharma. You are making mistake and you are going to put some allegation again. Why? You are making mistake, you have no brain, no idea. What Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak? You are making some misinterpretation in front of people in the name of Varnasam Dharma. Who told you? Varnasam Dharma can be there. It is systematic. According to Vedic culture, according to the instruction of Krishna, we can have. But they should stay in their own position and try to get improvement. Follow. Not that Kshatriya can stand in Kshatriya position ever, not that. Maybe he has the scope to do bhajan, go up and get the Brahmin quality. Maybe. Vishwamitra Dishwe having Kshatriya quality. After that giving. Getting the title, honor from whom? Vasishtha Muni. Many times Vishwamitra approach. You give me this title, Brahmarshi. No, I cannot give. Why? You are not qualified. Then Vishwamitra wanted to take revenge against whom? Vasishtha Muni. But still, no, you are not qualified. Wanted to kill Vasishtha Muni one day Vasishtha Muni was talking with wife that this moonlight is just like the brightness, you know, exposed by the bhajan power of who? This Vishwamitra in hiding in bush, you know, hiding in bush to kill him. Automatically when he hear, he is speaking in front of wife. He is glorifying me. Oh my God. He go and throw himself onto the lotus feet of Vasishtha Muni. I have done mistake. Please excuse me. I am not qualified for a Brahmarshi title. Then Vasishtha Muni take him up in lap. And say, today you are going to get this quality of Brahmarshi. I can announce that you are Brahmarshi today. That Brahmarshi, we are ever grateful to Vishwamitra also. Because Vishwamitra giving us the Gayatri Mantra. This Gayatri Mantra came in front of Vishwamitra. Vishwamitra watching this Gayatri Mantra. And giving to us. So not that those rishi doing acting this way is one kind of play, drama. I have no right to speak that way, you know. So you see, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is not Sahajya. You can go to Chaitanya Sikshamrita, you can go to Jaiva Dharma, I can show you one by one. I also many times I was bound to publish, was who going to care a poor man like me? I published already. That there is no problem with Varnasam Dharma. The problem is there inside your heart, contamination. Brahman, well, they can do their own seva. Kshatriya can do their own seva. Vaishya can do their own seva. Shudra, they can all their own seva. Antaja, they can do their own seva. And those who are enjoying the privilege to get this quality, what? Paramarthik Brahmanatya. Achyuta Gatra. If they like to get take advantage of this Brahmanism, then Bhaktivinoda Thakur never approve. Bhaktivinoda write it clearly. I cannot break the system of this society. It is for good. Krishna arranged. This political leader, they are foolish enough to misunderstand Krishna. They cannot understand. They think we can cut all system and we can make one. No. Varnasam dharma is not itself. You are making contamination. You are making contamination. According to your quality, character, according to your seva mood, I mean, seva, I cannot use this word, but in material stage, seva, this word cannot be used. According to a mood, service, this society can be segregated. Not that you are sudra, you are doing khaini, taking khaini, doing biri, and you want to prove that I am Vaishnava. I cannot approve. I know everything. Guru Maharaj speak everything. Who is doing what? I cannot approve any free relation with brahmacharis and matajis. I cannot approve any free relation with any grihastha, with any other matajis. They should be careful if they are going to come in front of me. If they go away from me, I am not. If any other maharaj can approve dancing of matajis, they can do in stage. But I cannot approve. You can follow him. Don't come to me. If you follow me, you will have to come to me. I can give you seva. I can give you seva. If you have your power, I can give you gomata. I can take your responsibility. Prasadam I can give. You are ready to do seva? You are not ready, I know. Don't try to mix up. Some acharya can guide you that way. I am going to follow Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I am not going to make any new philosophy. I am not making my brain a factory. I can make new philosophy daily. I am not making that. Only I am repeating what already told by Guru Varga. My Guru Varga told, that is called Harikatha. Don't try to make anything new. Foolish number one. I cannot approve. Even in Indian society, intercaste marriage is also dangerous. Because the genetical fact, scientific ground, genetical factor is different, blood is different. It can be a big problem. You can go to foreign country and marry a lady. Oh, why? It's genetical factor different. Different. You can, even before marriage, at present doctors say you will have to test your blood. Your husband and wife, both you will have to test blood. Big problem. This way contamination going on. This is not at all varnasam dharma. This is not varnasam dharma. Daivya varnasam dharma. I cannot approve. It is not there anywhere. You cannot sow. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, even somebody coming here in mot, he is following brahmacharya dharma, he is following sannyas dharma, gradually going on sannyas. After sannyas dharma, out of the influence of maya, he fall down. Gate woman association. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, now no more he can identify himself with the previous title. Suppose in his previous home he was Chatterjee. Sam, follow. Previous in home he was enjoying that I am Brahman. Previous home. Try to follow what I mean to say. Previous home. He was Brahman, means not pure Brahman, maybe from, they are saying I am Chatterjee, Banerjee. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying, when you are going to lose your position as a sannyasi, then you are out of any varnasram, you are fallen soul. You cannot go back to home and say, I am now again, I could not successful, become successful as sannyasi, I am so, I can take this title again. Because You already live with that title and take Achyuta Gatra. Again you are going to this system, Bhaktivinoda Thakur never approved. You are going to ruin, you are going to destroy the whole system in Vaishnava society. Who told you are guiding? Who told you are guiding Vaishnava society? You are going to destroy, you are going to mislead them. Bhaktivinoda Thakur not saw here. You go through all the articles of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, very quickly you will have to translate. And you will have to represent free of cost. Bhaman Maharaj used to say, Kesava Maharaj used to say, if you give free of cost, they say, yeah, free of cost, they cannot read. Our Bhaktivallabha Tirthakara used to say, if you give free of cost, they say free of cost, they cannot read. At least you can take 10 rupees or 5 rupees, still they can read. Who told? Don't try to misguide the whole society. Try to follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur all the time. If you want to become a Gauriya, I cannot approve. You can leave me. You all can leave me. I don't bother. I can go away. But I cannot misguide you. That kind of marriage I cannot approve. I love those who are foreign devotees. They are enjoying maximum love from me. Maximum love. My Guru Maharaj used to say, they deserve more kippa, they deserve more credit. They are coming from so, you know, sophisticated society. How they are doing this kind of bhajan? How they? I am not from a big family. I am not from a rich family. So I am habituated to stay anywhere. I was from poor family. I can say clearly. So what is the credit with me? The credit is that they are coming from high family. They are rich, they are coming. They deserve more kippa. Tito Maharaj, you must go, give kippa to them. They are lying in darkness. So I have my love for all foreign devotees, irrespective of their Guru, and you know they are from ISKCON, so they cannot enjoy. Not that. I never speak like that. But I cannot anyway approve Sahajyaniti. I cannot approve. So this way, if you follow Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you can find what is the procedure, how you can go towards the lotus feet of Rupa Goswami path. Rupanugo Varayati. Namo Bhaktivinodayo Sachidananda Namini Gauru Shakti Sarupayo Rupanugo Varayati. We are going to pay Dandabhat and Dandabhat, innumerous Dandabhat, countless Dandabhat unto Lotus Feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. We are owe unto the Lotus Feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So I like to stop here. Many things I like to speak for hours. But time cannot permit. So here I like to stop Manchakalpatarushi ke basindu bevachu. Just stop rules and regulation in Mott. When I used to stay there, maybe he is knowing some information. So tough. No brahmachari can talk with Mataji. If I look from rooftop, five. Without any reason. No, Mataji. They cannot speak without any reason. Because usually I suggested those who are coming from foreign countries, they have some separate, you know, habituated. So I told during Harikatha they can get together, they can hear. After that, open mixing is not allowed. Those foreign devotees, they should be given wide acclamation. They are coming to accept my Siddhanta, Baba Pauba Siddhanta Bhaktivinoda. And they are coming to take the habit of those foreign devotees. They are from poor family. They come, from foreign country. So, can you arrange my foreign going? Yes. Can you arrange my foreign marriage? Why? That's why I told you, I suggested, if you want to get maximum result, I am not going to hate them. I love them. One big personality who are having control over a sense organ, they can take care of those foreign devotees. Not that common devotees can go openly In Mott, there was agitation against me. One Maharaj speaking in foreign country, doing all rubbish. I know everything. He's coming here. And one Mataji is there up. He is giving order to that Brahmachari. Hey, bread, some bread and milk you can go to that Mataji's room give. I said, no, he cannot go. And he go against me and make a party. After that, it was exposed that he is fallen soul. He has two or three sons from different source. They go all against me. Still he is in sannyas base. Still in sannyas. Who is going to stop them? This kind of contamination there. They can put some false allegation. I don't care. They can come. They can make a group. Still he is in sannyas base. Going to give upadesh. Whereas Bhaktivinoda Thakur say, no, you cannot do. So I cannot approve this. So tough rules and regulations. Whole society going against me. Go to hell. Yes, it's scientific. Those foreign people, those big, nice, you know, has nice character, controlling, they can take care of them. Why you send a small devotee there? He is from a poor, very lowest caste, is going to see, going to give bread? No. She can come and take bread here. Or you, sannyasi, you can go and give bread. And discover your relation with that Mataji. I am not going to speak that way. Foolish. Vanchakalpa Dharvasya.